Philippine factory activity expanded at a slower pace in the first month of 2024, according to the S&P Global Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index. The country's PMI fell to 50.9 in January from December's 50.1. Despite the slowdown, though, Manila's factory score was still above the 50 mark, separating growth from contraction. Also, according to the S&P report, Asia's manufacturing sector kicked off the year with broad improvements. South Korea saw one of the best increases, moving into expansionary territory up to 51.2. Regional equities falling after the U.S. Federal Reserve kept interest rates unchanged. The central bank also signaled that an interest rate cut in March is unlikely, dampening expectations it will start cutting rates in the first quarter.
We believe that our policy rate is likely at its peak for this tightening cycle, and that, if the economy evolves broadly as expected, it will likely be appropriate to begin dialing back policy restraint at some point this year. But the economy has surprised forecasters in many ways since the pandemic, and ongoing progress toward our 2% inflation objective is not assured. The economic outlook is uncertain, and we remain highly attentive to inflation risks.
This decline comes even after the S&P 500's Purchasing Managers Index showed Asia's factory activity saw broad improvements in January. We'll tell you more about that later on the program. In the meantime, let's look at the board now. Only South Korea's KOSPI Index is trading in the green among major Asian indices after Seoul's exports rose by the most in 21 months. Hong Kong's Hang Seng Index, meanwhile, is down 0.2% after the city-state's economic growth missed expectations. In the land down under, the ASX 200 snapped an 8-day winning streak, closing at 75.88. Taking a look now at futures in Europe, they are pointing to a mixed open ahead of Eurozone inflation figures and the Bank of England's policy decision. Contracts tied to the London's FTSE are down nearly 0.5%. Over in Wall Street, futures are edging higher as day after the U.S. Fed's decision. Focus stateside returns to earnings with heavyweights Apple, Amazon, and Meta set to report. Investors hoping for better news after the disappointment from Alphabet and Tesla. Now, BMI, a unit of Fitch Solutions, expects Philippines' economic growth to miss government target as a turnaround in trading activity remains unlikely. BMI is expecting Manila's GDP growth to accelerate to 6.2%, a figure that is below government's target of 6.5 to 7.5%. Now, this projection comes after the country's economy expanded by 5.6% in 2023, short of government's 6 to 7% target range. The Asian Development Bank's climate financing pledges the Asia-Pacific reach a record high in 2023. Now, the multilateral lender says it is committed, it committed $9.8 billion to the region last year. This was 46% higher year on year. Broken down, that's $5.5 billion going to mitigation, while $4.3 billion were for adaptation to extreme weather events. The ADB says among its flagship climate projects last year was a $1 billion loan for the Philippines to deploy a large-scale electric bus system in Davao City. ADB President Masatsugu Asakawa says the ongoing climate crisis poses a threat to the region's energy and agriculture sectors. He also reaffirmed the bank's commitment to help developing nations transition to cleaner energy sources.
The Bangsamoro Transition Authority rejects the proposal of former President Rodrigo Duterte for a separate and independent Mindanao. Duterte said a signature campaign has already begun for this endeavor and that he has tasked former House Speaker Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez to lead the effort. But Bangsamoro Transition Authority Deputy Parliament Speaker Omar Yasser Sema asserts cessation is not the solution.
Both fronts have already abandoned their call for secession. And in fact, the MILF have downgraded their call for the establishment of an Islamic State to a meaningful and genuine self-governance. And currently, we can say that both fronts are doing well in the Bangsamoro transition process. And the situation does not allow us, you know, it's not even, there's no basis to go back to the call for secession. Kung may problema naman ho yata sa how the system works, we even need to go back to the Constitution. And there are processes there that that can be availed of to settle all our problems. And in fact, charter change nga ho, is a remedy to solve our problems. And it's not necessarily secession.
Let's now open the new month in corporate stories. Robinson's Retail seeing lower overall profit in 2023. The Gokongwei-led firm's net income declined by more than 27%. That's at 4.6 billion pesos from the 6.4 billion in 2022. Its net income attributable to equity holders of the parent company fell by nearly 30%. Robinson's points to the weaker peso as well as to losses in equitized earnings and in startup investments. It also says the figure was affected by the derecognition of Robinson's Bank's net income after the lender's merger with the Bank of the Philippine Islands. Meanwhile, Abacor Capital approves the sale of a property of its subsidiary in Batangas Province. The 30,000 square meter property in Mabini Town will be sold at a contract price of 307 million pesos. Abacor expects to generate some 227 million pesos in gross profit from the undertaking. For Basic Energy Corporation, it signed a deal with an electric cooperative in Pangasinan Province. The agreement will allow the company to develop a potential 50-megawatt solar power project in the area. Finally, mobile wallet service GCash explains the unavailability of the app on Google Play Store. The Ayala's fintech company says it is updating some features of the app for Android users. It said users can still use their downloaded app and their funds will remain intact. GCash is also working with Google Play to make it available once more on the online store.